The government is unable to show MPs Brexit impact assessments for different sectors of the UK economy because they don't exist, David Davis has admitted. The Brexit Secretary put himself on a collision course with furious MPs who accused him of a total dereliction of duty, as he said that no systematic impact assessment had been undertaken by the government. The House of Commons voted at the start of November to demand that ministers hand over the assessments, but MPs were left disappointed at the apparent paucity of material which was eventually released. That prompted suggestions that Mr. Davis may have been in contempt of Parliament for failing to comply with the exact wording of the motion agreed by MPs. But he told the Brexit Select Committee the reason his department for exiting the European Union had not handed over the impact assessments was that such work had not been undertaken. David Davis, the Brexit Secretary, gives evidence to the Brexit Select Committee on Wednesday. Credit PA, he said, the first thing as we started out saying is the motion asked for things that don't exist. That's the point. It asked for things that don't exist. I had tried to get as close to that as I could within the parameters that my duties as a minister allow. Mr. Davis said in June that the government had 50, nearly 60 sector analyses already done on the impact of Brexit, and in October he said that work had been undertaken in excruciating detail. But Mr. Davis said on Wednesday that sectoral analyses was not the same as an impact assessment. He said, I have not used phrases like impact assessment except to say we don't have one. That's not my phrase. Sectoral analysis was used for a real reason. It's the analysis of what the sector looks like. After the admission, Hilary Benn, the Labour chairman of the committee, repeatedly pushed Mr. Davis on the issue, leading to a tense exchange between the pair. Mr. Benn asked if there was an impact assessment for the automotive sector or aerospace, to which Mr. Davis said there was not. Mr. Benn then asked if there was one for financial services, and Mr. Davis replied, I think the answer is going to be no to all of them. The revelation that no impact assessments have been carried out prompted Angela Eagle, the senior Labour MP, to accuse Mr. Davis of a total dereliction of duty, while others called on him to resign. David Lammy, a Labour MP and vocal Remain supporter, tweeted, at what point is David Davis going to be held to account for such blatant lying? He must surely now resign. He simply can not be allowed to go around lying to Parliament and the British public in this way. Mendacious, conceited, vain, duplicitous, wholly unfit for office. Tim Farron, the former leader of Liberal Democrats, also called for Mr. Davis to quit. He said, David Davis needs to go. He has mislead Parliament, and under his leadership the Brexit Department has turned incompetence into an art form. Brexit Bulletin, an essential briefing on the day's politics, news-free and direct your inbox each afternoon. A number of MPs raised Mr. Davis's comments with the Commons Speaker John Bercow to ask if the Brexit Secretary was in contempt of Parliament. Mr. Bercow said he would consider any representations from the Brexit Select Committee on the matter before coming to any conclusion. The Brexit Select Committee subsequently said that the government had complied with the terms of the motion agreed by MPs, making the prospect of contempt proceedings much less likely.